Deepak Jasani is with us, Head of Retail Research at HDFC Securities. Deepak, hi, good afternoon. I wanted your thoughts first on Sun Pharma, since that's the stock which has really been stock of the day today for all the wrong reasons. 390 on the stock now as we speak. Your thoughts?
Good afternoon. Now, Sun Pharma basically, like the other two mature pharma stocks, have had seen a sell-off a few months back. The street was broadly comfortable as long as the fall was due to FDA inspection or due to litigation in the US about their launches. But the latest reason of being corporate governance or related party transactions or tax issues, this is something the street is a little more discomfort with. So in that sense, the company will give a clarification. The street will again debate whether that clarification is worthy to be relied upon and to what extent. Analysts will have their own views. So net-net, I think having broken the technical levels of 391 and the stock finding it difficult to go above 391, it means that fresh downside could keep happening in the stock, and you can only trade in the stock when you think that the impact of the latest event is out. I think investment, you will have to wait for investments till a lot of clouds are cleared.
Okay, speaking of clearing clouds, they seem to be getting cleared for Alkem Laboratories. The stock just shot up because of that news. No Form 483 after the US FDA inspection. Otherwise, extremely range-bound through the course of the year. But not Sun Pharma, Alkem, yeah, that's the one that shot up. But also, equally quickly, some profit-taking is also setting in. Deepak, you know, just want to get your thoughts on, you know, something like HUL. Great numbers, no problem whatsoever with volumes. But the market seems to be a little hesitant now in buying these stocks at current prices, given where the multiples already are. How would you look at the staples universe?
Yeah, so staples, consumer staples has been a preferred or a favorite sector for most strategists and most analysts in the current circumstances. But one will have to be aware of the valuations which you have mentioned. Valuations are quite stiff. And the fact that for the last four or five or maybe more quarters, they have reported good numbers continuously. So now we are sort of pricing the stock for perfection. So in that sense, moving up from here would be a little difficult unless we see a lot of FI flows or domestic funds, domestic investment coming into the mutual funds. So till that time, I think probably the stock could remain range bound, susceptible to minor sell-offs.
The one stock which has seen quite a bit of sell-off despite very good numbers, Deepak, is Zee Entertainment. your thoughts? Clearly, there's more, you know, something more than what meets the eye in terms of what's happening here. You know, the promoter stake sale and everything, of course, in question right now. But as a stock at 440, your thought process?
Yeah, so now I think even Sun TV is down for that matter. So I think it is more to do with the space as such. In addition to the fact that the promoters are planning to pare their stake in the company. So whenever such situation arises, then a lot of questions will arise about whether they have been following proper practices, whether whatever has been displayed is the right picture or not, etc., etc. So such things, and the fact that they have not been able to find out a suitable match or a suitable buyer so far for their stake, probably could mean that the process could take longer than what people expect, and that is why tired bull liquidation could be happening from the FNO side or even from some investors.
You know, we were discussing this for a bit 2-3 days back. We discussed the fact that, you know, the market's message is important here on good numbers on a stock which had anyway not seen a rally. It was still down, and you know, it was really bizarre the way promoter straight away had come and said that, you know, selling the stake. Before that, the way the stock had spectacularly fallen from 600 to 400. I think this really is turning out to be a very interesting story.
Again, we need people to speak up. We need promoters to speak up and not leave the market guessing. Just wish that happens in stocks like Sun Pharma and Z Entertainment soon enough. Deepak, let's talk about one of the big movers of the day and, of course, you know, last several months as well. Reliance Industries market seems to be taking the numbers with both hands in the core business and also extremely excited about, you know, the retail as well as the telecom business. And at the same time, we're seeing so much of pressure on a beaten down name like Bharti Airtel. Would you go with this trade, the consensus trade that's playing out today? Do you think this is going to be the theme over the next several months as well?
Yeah, on the telecom space, we have been cautious for quite some time now, whether it is Idea or Bharti, because of this competition from the incumbent. Their business models and have gone sort of bizarre. And secondly, the continuous need for capex, whether it is spectrum, license fees or setting up towers and such like. So that sort of is pulling down their return ratios and sort of endangering their balance sheets. So, but on the other hand, Reliance, I think there are two camps. One is who is very bullish on the stock and the other not so bullish. People generally would feel that the telecom and the retail space has been performing well. The other two, the refining and the petrochemical, are broadly commoditized in sectors. So now, till the if the company is going to split up, there is the expectation building up that there could be a restructuring of the company, maybe 6 months down the line or 12 months down the line, where you would be given free shares of different segments. On the other hand, the capital ratios are not, the return ratios are not so great, and the debt, the gross debt is too heavy on the books. So these two things are sort of offsetting each other. But for the time being, I think the stock is having a good time.
All right, we'll leave it there today, Deepak. Thanks a lot for your time today. It was good talking to you. We'll take a break. Up next, we'll have the BTSC call with the news that the mid-cap index is at the low point of the day. The Nifty and the Sensex may not reflect the pain, but it's a bit of a decline that we're seeing in the broader market today.